Hi, it's Jill Harrington with Veg Tip of the Week. Today we're gonna do something fun. We're gonna make a pie. Everyone asks me about what to do with their sweet tooth. Here's a great thing about this pie, as you'll see. It's raw, so it's no cooking, meaning it's just pure fruit and dates. It tastes scrumptious. Technically, it could be dessert first. You could really have this as your main meal because it's just fresh fruits and dates, which I guess is a fruit because it has a pit. Little salad on the side, then you're totally safe. It's a great thing to prepare for guests or if you're going to someone's house, and it's just nothing but whole natural foods. So I want to start first because I noticed, you know, when I was setting up for this, I want you to take a look at the pure colors of nature, of fruit. It's so attractive. It's nature calling you, saying this is what you're supposed to eat. Red strawberries, red deep raspberries, the oranges, the bananas. It's just gorgeous. Okay, so back to work. We're gonna start with, it's a pound of strawberries, so 16 ounces of strawberries. And I'm gonna take half of those and make a puree out of it. So we're gonna throw them in a blender. Stick the lid on and make a little noise. Unfortunately, it needs a little of water. I'm gonna try that one more time. No, it doesn't. About that. It took a minute, but I knew if you put water in it, it was going to make it too watery. So this is just, look at this. Ah, oh, that is so beautiful. This is just strawberries. And by the way, at the end of this, I'm going to show you what to do if you don't want to hassle with making a pie and you just want the taste. So bear in mind, I'll show you a really simple way to do this also. But that was step one. So now we're going to add this to our rainbow of beautiful colors over here. So now a crust. Okay, I said it's a pie and it's a raw pie, which means of course that it's not cooked, and it's a healthy crust. So how do you make a healthy crust? For this, it's pretty essential to have a food processor. As you can tell, this is probably a 80s food processor, but it works great. It's not very pretty, and eventually I'll get a nice shiny one to put on camera here, but it just shows you that you could pick one of these up at a yard sale for a few dollars. It doesn't have to be a fancy one. You need the S blade, and the crust is made of dates and nuts. Now, if you want, because nuts are much higher in calories, dense, and have some fat. You can make the crust with just dates if you want, and I've done that before, but it makes it a little richer with nuts, so today we're gonna do it with both. If you were gonna do the crust with just dates, it would be 2 cups of dates. We're gonna use 1 cup of dates and then 1 cup of nuts. I'm using all almonds, but you could use almonds, mix that with some walnuts, even mix a few cashews or pecans in if you want to. Let's talk for a minute about a date. As many of you know, I used to live in California, Marin County, and there at the farmer's market, there would be fresh dates off of the trees every week. So I'm a bit spoiled, but here in Richmond, Virginia, I've still found dates. They're fresh dates. This is what one looks like. It's a fruit, and it has a pit. All fruit has a seed or a pit. So you just open it up, either with a knife or with your fingers like that, and take the pit out. And so this is 1 cup of dates, which is about a half a pound or a little bit less, actually, of a half a pound. And we're gonna put that into the food processor. And then the almonds, what I did was soak them in water for about 4 hours. You don't have to do that. But you know, an almond is waiting to turn into a tree, right? And so nuts in general are dried and they're dormant because they're not sprouting. Like if you had a potato and you just left it on your counter, it would start sprouting, right? Because it wants to produce more potatoes. Well, nuts store until they get moisture. Once they get moisture, then their enzymes are released and they start to grow. And so when you soak it, they taste better because they're not as dried and shriveled, and you don't have to soak them that long in order for them to become plumper and softer. So you don't have to soak them, but I think it really helps. So we're gonna add a cup. This was a cup of almonds. Now this is definitely gonna make a little racket. The most important thing with this, you'll see, hopefully you'll see, let's see if we can get the camera in on this, that it's going to form a ball. That's when you'll know when it's ready. So I put the food processor on, it's called momentary, meaning, you know, I just pulse it a little bit at a time. And for some reason, it didn't like that. All right. That's why the lid came off. I thought I'd blown a fuse. So I'm pulsing it so it doesn't immediately just mix everything up, because I want it to form that dough ball. Almost. When you use just dates, it forms that ball much faster. Okay, so when it's clumped together like that, it's made a big ball and now it's ready. So you take a pie pan, take this crust. Now there are a couple things you could add to this, depending on what type of pie I'm making. If I'm making a cinnamon pie, I mean not a cinnamon pie, if I'm making an apple pie, I add a little bit of cinnamon to the crust. But I didn't think cinnamon would taste all that great with strawberry. You can also add a little bit of vanilla if you want. All right, so this is now a ball, and we're just going to press it out into the pie crust, I mean to the pie pan. You could get fancy if you want and make little indentions in the side, but we're going to do the kind of the basics here. And as you can see, this is a lot easier than making a regular pie crust. Not that I've ever made a regular pie crust, but I've used the prepared kind before, and I can tell by looking at it, it would be a lot more work than this. Even children love this. I say even children, it's very sweet. Why wouldn't children love it? But it's a great, you don't have to tell them it's raw, you don't have to tell them it's healthy. You just tell them you've got a strawberry banana pie for them. And there's some recipes in the book, both in my recipe book as well as the main lupus recovery diet. Let's see, there's a key lime pie in there and a coconut cream pie, and they all use the same crust. All right, now normally something like this I would do in advance, but I want you to see that it really is simple. Anna, even my sister, who I'm sure was gonna watch this, could say that she could do this. She thinks I chop too much. But she doesn't like to cook. But voila, I love that word. Voila, there's a pie crust. All right. Now, to fill this crust, we're going to take some bananas, 3 or 4 bananas, and slice them long ways. You could do little rounds if you wanted to, but what we're doing is forming a bottom crust there. Let's see, I'll drop this into my trash can. And you just kind of mush it around on the bottoms and the side of the pie. Now, once again, as always with bananas, it's really important that the bananas be ripe. I don't know if you noticed those bananas had a few little spots on them. If you do this with any unripe fruit, it just is not sweet. It just doesn't taste good. So you do, bananas are one of those things you do have to kind of plan in advance for. See, there's a few spots on here, which means it's ripe, but they don't have to be overripe, but you definitely want them ripe. So we're going to slice again. Let's see, this was only 3, and this is going to be plenty. And bear in mind, if you weren't doing this on film and trying to keep it under 10 minutes, you could make it even a little fancier than I'm doing here. But I love to cook. I really do. I love to prepare food, but I don't like to spend a lot of time doing it. I like quick and easy recipes. So that's why I'm smearing this around here pretty quickly. All right, so now we've got the banana layer. Now let's take our strawberries, which are already washed. People know I cannot be trusted with knives. Luckily, I'm cutting it the wrong way. Luckily, these are also dull knives, so I really can't hurt myself even if I cut all the way through. There we go, that's the way to do it. Now there are a few, and I'm gonna do an episode on this. People ask me about organic all the time, and yes, organic is very important for so many reasons. For your health, for the minerals and vitamins that are in organic food that's not in non-organic food, for the earth. There's so many reasons to eat organic, but there's a list of, say, 10 fruits and vegetables that are extremely important to eat organic. And strawberries is number one on that list. So what that means is whatever they have to spray on strawberries in order to farm them in quantity is something really toxic. And of course, it's going right on the fruit. So it's being absorbed into the skin. So it's one of those things that I pretty much only eat organic. There are others I'm more flexible on. And if you absolutely can't get them, you can't get them. It's certainly better than a lot of other things that people are eating. Now look at this. See, this is only, we had 1 pound, which of course is 16 ounces. And that is plenty of strawberries there. Mushing them all down into the banana. All right, now we take this strawberry sauce that we made, which was just strawberries, right? Spread that over top. Is this looking delicious or what? Put it down into the... And in case you haven't noticed, I'm definitely a cook and prepare food with your hands kind of person, particularly when it's this food. The smell is unbelievable. The smell of these fresh strawberries and the puree coming up to me is just amazing. Fresh raspberries, you can use any fruit that you have. Blueberries would be wonderful with this, but raspberries are just so nice and decadent. So we're going to make a ring of those around here. And then these are oranges. I'm trying to remember the name of the orange. It started with an M. It wasn't mandarin, because I think mandarins maybe are always in cans. I guess they're fresh somewhere. But it's, I like to use oranges in recipes that are have a really thick skin on the outside, a soft, thick skin, because they're generally plumper and better to use in a recipe. Okay, so we have raspberries in the middle. We have raspberries in between. And you would put this in the refrigerator for about an hour just to chill and set. And I promise you, anyone that you serve this to is going to love it. That was your sweet tooth tip of the week. Hope you enjoyed it.